What else has happened?
Funny, there was no answer.
Hello, baby. This is Super Spade. How are you? That's a drag, man.
Give me room 809, please. This is Super Spade. How are you? Fine. What are you going to be doing later on this afternoon? Could be a groovier scene if you came over here.
Take me about 2 years to be one, and I'll come back.
How soon do you expect her back? You know, I get in touch with either one of them.
Yeah.
The sound of one's name is... everybody likes to hear it, and seeing you, I can... it's very characteristic that you are quite evident of the fact.
Right, Super Spade. Spade, right. Let me spell it for you? S-P-A-D-E. Pardon? We're going to have a little groovy thing happen tonight, and I'd like for you to stop by. We're two doors down from me in room 807. What's the address? This is Super Spade, baby. How do you spell that? Well, the capital S. Two capital S's. Right. Oh, well, tonight's your final night. About 9:30. What about 7 o'clock, how's that? Okay, then I'll expect you at 7:30. Would it be better at 6:30 than 7 o'clock? Well, I don't know if I can wait that long. Well, I'll call you at 7:30. Okay, bye-bye. Ooh-wee, mama. Sure did look good.
To let me prepare myself for a thing like this.
What time?
Thank you.
sure. That's why he'll never be coy or screw around. All the other mongrels are where his scene's out of sight. Yeah, uptight, straight, and a pedigree are just a dog.
I am what I eat, and it is what you eat is what you are. And really, that is something.
I don't know why I'm here talking to you. I'm not the religious type. I was. The other night I was in Grosse Pointe, Michigan. Sort of a dreadful place, I think.
Now, you remember the situation there where our little friend is in the laundry wagon.
It's kind of interesting.
Now, here, the first picture is the laundry wagon. It's a yellow laundry wagon. It means that dirty money never brings any luck.
On this 1,316th day of American democracy at war against the foes of freedom, we bring you our mayor, the Honorable F.H. LaGuardia, speaking to you today from his desk in City Hall in another Talk to the People. Ladies and gentlemen, His Honor the Mayor.
Patience and fortitude.
I wasn't attacking you.
That's me when I run for mayor. Yes, or run for Congress. He's putting up a big front. But if you look closely on the picture, you'll see lines under his eyes. You'll see that haunted look at him. You know why?
My apologies for leaving, but we are students, and my date must return to the dorm before midnight.
Well, I'm a dead duck. Because public officials who do not do their duty can't sleep at night. They're haunted. They pretend to be happy. They may think that they're happy, but they're not.
On this 1,309th day of American democracy at war against the foes of freedom, we bring you our mayor, the Honorable F.H. LaGuardia, speaking to you from his desk in City Hall in another Talk to the People. Ladies and gentlemen, His Honor the Mayor.
Here's Dick Tracy.
I just certainly didn't come here for any moralizing or a sermon of any kind, but have you anything to say?
Yeah? Do you like them?
In a while, not right now.
We just have about time to read Little Orphan Annie.
Say when, baby.
Listen, baby. I know you're a maid at Van Hoosen's. I saw you there last week.
Leave me alone.
But, Uncle Spig, she's innocent until proved guilty.
So, therefore, I really think the government should subsidize these teenagers, particularly the girls.
And she has all of the money in bills in a pillow slip. Easy, sister, easy. Annie is helpless. She's just their meat. And then the next picture is that of the warden of the jail. You know, you remember his picture. He's a kindly gentleman. And it made Miss Pullet and the rest of her kind look like fools. That only makes that sort more bullheaded and vindictive.
You're not giving us any space. And we can't get people.
They come from homes like you and me. Like your home and my home. They come with experience.
From his desk in City Hall, we have brought you Mayor F.H. LaGuardia in another of his weekly talks to the people. And may we remind you that at 8:45 each morning, WNYC broadcasts a list of the arrival of ships bearing troops from overseas.
And crash! Knocked out.
I should have pointed out that...
Why, yes, that's my mother. My mother thought I did a marvelous job considering patience and fortitude.
I know you mean well and are doing wonderful work respectfully.
And say, children, what does it all mean?
Two and two are four. Four and four are eight. It becomes astronomical. It eventually leads to where we couldn't have any breathing space. So therefore, something, as sorry as I may say, has to remove us from this earth.
Moments of the soft persuasion, chiming bells the first occasion. Tell the rest a smile. Reminder shaken from whatever root and sorrow. Now the time is now, tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Silly girl, what will your mother say? Ah, you look so tired and you've gone so far away. Take me away, smile the simple smiles, and go to sleep and dream another way, and dream another way.
Extremely overcast, but my heart is very light. Thank you. In the summertime, I create a winter scene. This is icicles. I was so impressed with my art years ago that I wanted somebody to come and take pictures of it.
Thank you.
My soul flutters when I hear dancing. Wow. That's enough.
Thank you.
yesterday was Bastille Day. It's the French 4th of July.
It's like living in a chimney, which is your altar. But like, it's no problem. You just learn how to do that, and then you can do it. And a fire is something that we've been living with for 2 million years as social animals, talking to one another in some way, and sitting around warming ourselves and looking into the fire at night, you know? And you got a fire, man, that's what's happening in your house, in the center of your house. Your house that has no corners. Your round house, you know, the world. I don't remember how that whole number went down, hardly. The idea came in at one point, and I got to the point of cutting a bunch of poles, and I was trying to figure out how to sell this thing. Instead of catching it, wood that spits, you know. I don't know, to be out of your mind is to be able to, you know, get out of your conscious mind is to be able to get a little wider grasp of consciousness, of real consciousness. Eternal now, future past, all one cosmic moment.
I had 10 people living in here.
Indians, isn't that right?
My name is Jack and I live in the back of the Greta Garbo home. With friends I will remember wherever I may roam. My name is Jack, I live in the back of the Greta Garbo home for wayward boys and girls. Now here's old Fred with his hands on his head, cause he thinks he's heard the bomb. And here comes Super Spade, who really gets it on. And my name's Jack, I live in the back of the Greta Garbo home for wayward boys and girls. Diggers found. Ruth is always praying and never makes a sound. It's lots of fun and I love to run up and down the stairs. I make as much noise as I want and no one even cares. And my name's Jack, we live in the back of the Greta Garbo home for wayward boys and girls. Funny hair, he's never sad at all. And when I grow up, I want to run as fast as my friend Paul. There's the prettiest girl in the whole wide world, and her name is Melody Mend. And here comes Mom with brother Tom, who's probably my best friend. And my name's Jack, I live in the back of the Greta Garbo home for wayward boys and girls. We all home
like the mad ashram. You know, the madman can't get along with the people. It freaks the people right out. But the spiritual men can go and talk to them.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because the madmen are out of their minds. And it seems that, you know, that there's just a few people that can talk with these people. And they're... source of strength in understanding humanity, right? By understanding how humanity can not keep track of it.
It's such a long story. This place here had been in my mind since I was 7 years old. I knew that it would come to pass that I could create this here. And my life had its beginning from adversity.
Shorts out, then it's all the water, you know, it's all the underneath thing. Cat running across the field today towards us. He was just tripping out like a kid, fascinated, right? I'm sure he wasn't uptight.
I think a teepee is an interesting place to live because...
I don't know how many times anybody comes with a motorcycle, I'm terrified. This poor man he was driving a motorcycle and he was killed taking pictures of the Pope when he came here to this country. Nut and found out what he can do, I'm afraid this population explosion will fall upon us. Say, for instance, 1,000 years ago.
Don't remind me now of time. I know the years will change my mind. Don't stir the silence in your eyes, and don't say the words that may be lies. Oh, and if I ask you to be kind, it's just what's on my mind.
It's just what's on my
It's free and it's on the inside. Just a little bit closer. Let me have your attention. This is the one you've heard about. This is the free one. This is the one that doesn't cost you a cent.
Hey, kids, these are the cars with the lucky numbers. These cars are being given away free. Free car with the winning ticket. Free, free. These cars that sell for over $3,000 are yours free if you hold the winning ticket. Free, free.
Free, free, free. Free, free.
Hey kids, get your lifetime psychedelic dance lesson. The Froo, the Watusi, the Boogaloo.
Uh-oh, I'm sorry. Lifetime psychedelic dance lesson. Work out, baby.
Good guys wear 'em, and so can you.
Say, babies, get in on what's happening. Here's an item that's always groovy. It's not gonna wear out, it's not gonna be out. It's gonna be in, be in. Wear it to be ins, wear it to love ins, wear it to turn ins. Your Nazi helmet is factory fresh and comes with a choice of personalized decals. Made of the finest organic plastic, this item will never become obsolete. Kids? Get your own helmet club. Plan secret meetings. Wear your helmets to school. Compare your genuine now helmet to Dad's old one. Guarantee complete protection in all demonstrations. Hey kids, get up tight with your out of sight Nazi helmet today.
Good guys wear 'em, and so can you.
Grow up, be young, wear glasses.
Be your own type of world, your own happy way.
One thing,
see the USA in your plastic Nazi helmet through your psychedelic glasses.
Right, right, each and every trial, and wouldn't be all together with it, wouldn't.
Oh!
about you, babe?
What about you, babe? Thank you, thank you.
And I create skin, and I think it will be an introduction to the world of skin being created upon art. Our poor Indians.